Let it rain. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it.
Our Father in heaven, we thank you this morning. Almighty Father, we worship and adore you. That song writer says, great is the Lord, and you are greatly to be praised. In the city of our God and the mountain of your holiness, you are beautiful for situations. You are the joy of the whole world. Father, we have come to hear from the throne of grace. Holy Spirit, please speak to us this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, I commit all our listeners unto you. I pray you will speak to them in the name of Jesus. Bible said the Lord sent a word unto Jacob, and that word lighted upon Israel. Father in heaven, you will send your word this moment to your people. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed. Amen and amen. Once again, let me say good morning. You are welcome to Open Heaven Studio. And today, the 25th of July, 2020, we want to give God the glory. Today we shall be looking at dangers of backsliding, part 2. Yesterday we looked at dangers of backsliding, part 1. And today we shall be looking at the concluding part of that series, dangers of backsliding, part 2. And we shall be taking our memory verse from Luke chapter 9. Verse 62, Luke chapter 9, verse 62. Scripture says, and Jesus said unto him, no man, having put his hands on the plow, and looking back, is fit for the kingdom of God. No man, having put his hands on the plow, and looking back, is fit for the kingdom. The grace not to look back, I pray for you, receive it now in the name of Jesus. So let's take our text from that same chapter of the scripture, Luke chapter 9, and we shall be reading from verse 59 to 62. Luke chapter 9, verse 59 to 62. And the scripture says, and he said unto another, follow me. But he said, Lord, suffer me first to go and bury my father. Jesus said unto him, let the dead bury their dead, but go thou and preach the kingdom of God. And another one also said, Lord, I will follow thee, but let me first go bid them farewell, which are at home at my house. And Jesus said unto him, no man, having put his hands to the plow and looking back, is fit for the kingdom. No man, having put his hands on the plow and looking back, is fit for the kingdom. Praise be the name of the Lord. Like I said, we are looking at dangers of backsliding, part 2. Dangers of backsliding, part 2. Daddy wrote here, he said, backsliding is horrible. Backsliding is horrible. 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 20 to 22, the Bible says it is better not to have tasted salvation than to have been saved once and then backslide. Amen and amen. There was a book I read many years ago. It was titled The Sorrow of Backslider. Praise be the name of the Lord. There is always sorrow for a backslider. And when you read the scripture, 2 Peter chapter 2 from verse 20, 2 Peter chapter 2 from verse 20 to 22, scripture says something there. Let's look at that quickly. 2 Peter chapter 2. Praise be the name of the Lord. 2 Peter chapter 2. Hallelujah. Chapter 2 from verse 20 to 22 says, "For if after they have escaped the pollution of the world through the knowledge of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, they are again entangled therein and overcome, the latter end is worse with them than the beginning. For it had been better for them not to have known the way of righteousness than after they have known it to turn from holy commandment delivered unto them. But it is happened unto them according to the true proverb, the dog is turned to his own vomit again, and the soul that was washed to a wallowing in the mire. Praise be the name of the Lord." So in Hebrews chapter 6, verse 4 to 6, Hebrews chapter 6, verse 4 to 6, scripture says, "For it is impossible for those who were once enlightened and have tasted of the heavenly gift and were made partakers of the Holy Ghost and have tasted the good word of God and the powers of the world to come, if they shall fall away, to renew them again unto repentance, seeing they crucify to themselves the Son of God afresh, and put him to an open shame." They put him to an open shame. Now, this passage describes backsliding as though the backslider were actually crucifying Jesus Christ again. From the scripture that we just read, Hebrews chapter 6 from verse 4 to 6, it appears from this scripture that the backslider are crucifying Jesus again. And in Acts chapter 1, the book of Acts chapter 1, from verse 15 to 20, the Bible tells us of the sorrows and torments of Judas Iscariot. Praise be the name of the Lord. Bible say he bought a land. Did he bought a land from the money he collected from, betraying Jesus, and he died headlong there. Praise be the name of the Lord. And his entry came out. You can imagine a man who was with Jesus for almost 3.5 years. He was a partaker of the grace of God, but yet he backslided. May that never be your portion. May that never be my portion in the name of Jesus. Now the Bible tells us of the sorrows and torment of Judas Iscariot. And when you read Luke chapter 15 from verse 11 to 17 tells us of the depression of the prodigal son. You know the story of the prodigal son. Praise be the name of the Lord. You can confirm that story in Luke chapter 15 from verse 11 to 17. But thank God, the man repented and came back to his senses and returned back to his father. Praise be the name of the Lord. May I say this to us, beloved brethren, and as many that are listening to me this morning, it does not matter how long you journey in a wrong direction. You can never get to your destination. Let me come again on that. I said, it does not matter how long you journey in a wrong direction. You can never get to your destination. Praise be the name of the Lord. What am I trying to say here? It is imperative for us to return back to Jesus. Praise be the name of the Lord. I pray for you. May you never backslid in the name of Jesus. But if in case you are backslided, praise be the name of the Lord. There's still time for us. There's still time for you to return back to your Maker. And the way the Father welcomed the prodigal son, our Jesus, his arm is open to welcome you back. Praise be the name of the Lord. In Psalm 51, after David had lost the joy of his salvation, he cried to God for it to be restored to him. David cried unto God. Praise be the name of the Lord. Can we quickly see Psalm 51 and see how David cried unto God there? Amen and amen. Bible says, "Have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according to the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned and done this evil in thy sight, that thou mightest be justified when thou speakest, and be clear when thou judgest. Behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Behold, thou darest truth in the inward part, and in the hidden part thou shalt make me to know wisdom. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me to hear joy and gladness, that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice. Hide thy face from my sin, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Then will I teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be comforted unto thee. Praise be the name of the Lord. This was a cry of a man who lost the joy of his salvation. And as he cried unto God, the joy of his salvation was restored back unto him. Praise be the name of the Lord. The devil knows what is to be close to Almighty God, and then to be far from Him. Devil knows what it is to be close to God, and he know what it takes to, and know what it is to be far from God. Praise be the name of the Lord. He was once close to God, but now he's so far from God. So he know what it is to be close to God. He also know what it is to be far from God. He know the benefit, the blessedness of being close to God. And he also knows the sorrow, the shame, the pain of being far away from God. He is aware of the sorrows of backsliding and losing contact with God. He is aware, is completely aware, is in the know of the sorrows of backsliding and the losing contact with God. And that is why his greatest desire is to lure you back to sin. That is the greatest desire of the devil, to lure us back into sin. And hear me well. If you have been lured back into sin, please find your way back to Jesus, because there is a sorrow that is waiting the backslider. But you will overcome him in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for you, as many under the sound of my voice, you will overcome him in the name of Jesus. And in 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8, 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8 says, "Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour." Walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. May you never be devoured in the mighty name of Jesus. May you never be deceived in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise be the name of the Lord. And Bible says, and our daddy wrote here, he said, just as God is looking for people to set aflame for his kingdom purpose, Satan is also looking for people to devour. John chapter 10, verse 10. That the fact that he is seeking, however, shows that he cannot devour everybody. He shows you all the glitters of the world and uses them as a bait. Please be careful. Don't ever let this thing entice you. The moment you get to the stage where the pleasure of this world do not matter to you anymore, he knows he has lost you. I pray for you, just as Jesus prayed for Peter, the devil will not get you in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for you, the devil will not get you, the devil will not get your household, the devil will not get me in the mighty name of Jesus. And we were told that the moment you get to that stage where the pleasure of this world does not matter to you anymore, devil knows that you have gone completely from him. Praise be the name of the Lord. The Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. And grace to stand firm for Christ, receive now in the mighty name of Jesus. And I pray for as many who has backslidden already, grace to return back to your maker, grace to find your way back to your Lord. Receive now in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. We are to sing the hymn, "Have You Been to Jesus for the Cleansing Blood?" Praise be the name of the Lord. And the key point says, backsliding is like crucifying Jesus afresh and putting him to open shame. Don't do it. Please don't do it. The Lord will help you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for your word that you have sent to us this morning. And we also want to give you praise for our father, our daddy that you have used to prepare this war. Oh God Almighty, we thank you because you have sent your word unto your people. We pray that your word will bring light and illumination to your people in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, King of Glory. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed. Till I come your way again tomorrow, remain rapturable. God bless you.
Have you been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully trusting in His grace this hour? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed?
Are you washed in the blood?
In the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you walking daily by the Savior's side? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Do you rest each moment in the crucified? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Are you washed?
Are you washed in the blood? In the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? When the bridegroom cometh, will your robes be white, pure and white in the blood of the Lamb? Will your soul be ready for the mansions bright and be washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed?
Are you washed in the blood?
In the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb. Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Lay aside the garments that are stained with sin and be washed in the blood of the Lamb. There's a fountain flowing for the soul unclean. Oh, be washed in the blood of the Lamb. Blood of the Lamb, are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the
sing out, yeah.